and scathing new allegations against Florida Power and Light.
Kathleen O'Toole got her hands on a letter accusing the company of fudging its numbers.
It's the company many of us trust to keep the lights on. But now, in another anonymous letter, a group of people who say they are employees say they were directed to purposely keep state regulators in the dark.
When they're not getting ready for the next storm, it seems FPL is dealing with a storm of controversy, like this time in western Palm Beach County, where protesters blocked the road at the site of a proposed new energy center. The latest storm comes in the form of another anonymous letter. The third in a string this year also claims to be from a group of employees writing to the FPL group, NextEra Energy chairman and board of directors. In a June 15th letter, they allege that the company had two separate sets of books. Quote, "This was done so we could have one set of numbers for PSC regulatory filings to inflate budgeted expenses and increase revenue requirements when actual expenses were far below that, and our business units were not authorized to use certain funds, even though these funds were officially in the budget."
I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, everybody has their hand in two pockets, seems like, politics.
Yeah, I definitely doubt whether, in fact, FPL would be keeping two sets of books. I've known a number of people in the power industry in the past, and if anything, they're religious about their bookkeeping.
Once again, the company would not speak on camera. Instead, it referred us to this. It's a statement that it actually made to the SEC regarding this third letter.
The statement says, quote, "These purported employees have written two previous anonymous letters that prompted two exhaustive investigations, neither of which found any evidence of any illegalities. The newest anonymous letter contains yet more of these unsupported and unsubstantiated allegations of fraudulent or other illegal conduct."
The people who wrote this letter say they are employees who have lawyers, have been to law enforcement, and want to be considered whistleblowers. The company says it set up a 24-hour hotline that employees can call anonymously with any concerns. Reporting in Juneau Beach, I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.
And this newest round of accusations comes shortly after the company announced widespread layoffs. FPL eliminated hundreds of positions because of the bad economy. About a third of those layoffs were from the Palm Beaches and Treasure Coast. The rest are from Broward and Miami-Dade County.